It's chilly.
It's chillier than I had expected.
It's gonna warm up here under the lights real quick, though,
okay,
I promise.
I'll take my coat off. Yeah. I forgot it.
Well, thank you so much for joining us here in chilly Edmonton. Sorry about that.
It's alright.
I don't know what happened. I didn't get the, it was still summer yesterday memo.
It's a good warm up for me, because it's so hot in Toronto right now. It's like beautiful flip flop weather.
It was like 30 degrees in Toronto yesterday. Well, it was just
it
so
was.
Weird. I know.
But it's okay, because this is just reminding me of what's to come.
Yeah, it's preparing you.
Very soon, right?
So you're a fairly recent Canadian citizen.
I am.
That's exciting. Yeah.
So I actually moved to Montreal in 2005 from Los Angeles. I was there for like 15 years, and I moved to sort of change my life, and I randomly went to Montreal to sort of decompress and tried to learn French, which I didn't. And then I got Flashpoint, which brought me to Toronto.
There's some Flashpoint fans in the crowd.
And then I just fell in love with Toronto and Canada in general, and I love it. So I've been here since 2005, but I became a citizen 3 years ago now. Thanks, guys.
You picked a great time. Just like
I agree.
Yeah.
Okay, we're not gonna talk about that.
It's fine. I think obviously we have a lot of Power Rangers fans in the room. Very exciting.
Yeah.
I would love to talk a little bit about your experience on that show right off the top. I heard it was actually really challenging for you physically.
Well, alright. The thing is, it was such a blessing in a way to get the show. It was my first job as an actress, and I had no idea what I was doing, and it was non-union. And so in hindsight, the experience I had on the show, thinking about it now, was a little nuts, because it was non-union, and there wasn't a lot of safety regulations and stuff going on. I did almost catch on fire a few times. Little things like that. But it was my first gig. So for me, it was like almost, in a way, like acting school, not acting school, but like my college years. Like, we had a lot of fun shooting that, if you know what I mean. Are there a lot of kids here? No, good. Yeah, we had a lot of fun. It was like, we were partying pretty hard. Yeah.
Because the Power Rangers were so wholesome, so I loved that, like.
I know, and then there we were in our early 20s, like, I remember, I've told this story before, so I don't want to bore you, but I was dating one of the grips. Do you know on a set, there's the electricians and the grips, and they like light the show. Anyway, we smoked a little pot before I got in my sword, and I was wearing my pink spandex. I remember just sitting in the sword, like, looking out. God, what was his name? Oh my lord. Well, Colin was a different guy, but I wasn't smoking pot with him. I was engaged to him. He was an electrician, too. Paul. So I remember looking out at Paul and being like, having this crazy reality check. Like, what has my life become? I'm in pink spandex on national television in a sword. Looking out at all the, like, the crew just looking at me. Smoke pot again while I'm shooting. It's too much.
Probably for the best.
Yeah.
And you made a guest appearance in the 2017 Power Rangers reboot.
Yeah, me and JDF got to go to Vancouver and get on the set and shoot, and it was fun just to be there and to. Did you guys like the new movie? I really liked it. Dean Israelite was the director. I thought he did a fantastic job. And it is a very different movie, clearly, from the TV show that I was in. Like, it was much more, it's much more mature. I think they made it so that the fans and the kids who are now grown up in their late 20s, early 30s, would appreciate the movie and like the new movie. So, I loved it.
You brought up, you brought up Jason David Frank. You guys do a lot of cons together.
Well, he does every con.
Yeah,
he is the king of the con. He has it down. He's so great. He's one of the funniest. Do you guys follow him on Instagram?
Yeah.
Did you see him like a week ago? It was the funniest video I think I've ever seen. He was one of those golf carts like going through this giant like auditorium, and he's hanging on to the back and like, oh my god, he's a nut. And he was a nut 25 years ago when we were shooting the show. He definitely kept the producers on their toes, that's for sure.
At San Diego this year, he said that he would love to see you direct Mighty Morphin Power Rangers Reunion.
Oh, yeah, you know, so I've started directing. In the last 5 years, I've transitioned from acting into writing and directing, and I've done like 3 short films, and my first feature film came out last summer. It's called The Space Between. You can check it out online. If you go to amyjojohnson.com, like all the movies I've done are on there, the shorts are on there. Anyway, this is my passion now. This is all I want to do is write and direct. And I'm actually gearing up to shoot my second feature, which I did not write, in November, and I'm really, really excited about it. Anyway, having said that, yes, when I was doing the Power Ranger cameo, Jason had mentioned that, so I actually asked the producers who do the TV show, I said, wouldn't that be great, because I do want to get into episodic directing, if my first episode, like the TV show that I direct is Power Rangers, like how apropos would that be, right? Well, didn't happen, guys. That's okay. Because I said, oh, the reunion, I would love to do that because they shoot New Zealand. So I was talking to them a little bit about it, and it didn't happen, but that's okay. Whatever.
I did actually want to talk to you about The Space Between, because you wrote, directed, and starred in that movie, which is like...
Yeah, it was a lot. I made sure that my role, my part in it, wasn't too big, that it wasn't overwhelming, but I really felt like I should be in the movie because I raised half the money to make the movie on Indiegogo through crowdfunding, through amazing people like you guys who had watched me as a Power Ranger and followed my career all the way up into this transition in my life. And so I have this amazing support system from all these kids who are now adults, which I find amazing. But it was definitely challenging, and actually the film, it's called Tammy's Always Dying, which I'm gonna start filming in November. I'm not gonna be in it, because I just really want to just focus on, I didn't write this one either, so I'm just truly focusing on directing this movie, which I'm really excited about.
That's amazing. I'm sure we're all super excited for it. Oh, we have a question over there. Hi. Anyone else who has a question, feel free to line up at the mics too.
Hi, I'm a huge fan of you. I followed you through the Power Rangers up to Flashpoint, and I was wondering in Flashpoint, how much training did it take to play your character and everything, and all the guns you had to use, all the entry points you had to use, how much training did you have to do for that?
So when I got the role of Jules, we spent like 2 weeks in prep and rehearsals with the actual task force in Toronto. They took us to their training center, and they kind of gave us training that they would normally have with like the role playing and putting yourself in situations and having to talk people off the ledge. It was super cool. And then we went shooting to a shooting range and learned how to shoot. And then on set, they would always have somebody from the police force or the SWAT team or something on set just to make sure things were as authentic as they could be. Sometimes story wise. But the crazy part was for myself, because I was the only woman on the team, right? But I got the job. I had decided to quit acting, and then I got the call for Flashpoint. I was like, no, I don't want to act anymore. And then they kept calling. They really wanted me, which was very flattering and so nice. But I found out I was pregnant, like literally at the same time. So I was like, telling my agent, I was like, just tell them I'm pregnant. They're not gonna want me. They're like, no, well, that'd be great. That's fine. I'm like, what? Okay, then I guess I have to, like, this is meant to be.
Yeah.
So the entire first season of Flashpoint, my hormones were out of control. I was so pregnant, like very pregnant. By the end, they were hiding me behind like garbage cans and stuff. And they had to shoot me. the end of season one, just in case, you know, I didn't want to come back or couldn't come back because I was about to go off and have a baby. So it was really intense, and I have to tell you, it was one of the best experiences of my life. Doing Flashpoint grounded me as a person because I had left LA because I was just sort of falling apart. And getting this role as Jules, one, having a baby, I think grounds anybody, but then also playing this sniper and like, and it took me that whole season while being pregnant to really like learn how to sit in my own skin, if that makes any sense. Like the whole show gave me a lot of confidence.
And it was shooting in Toronto, so it was sort of, you were finding your new home a little bit.
Yeah, I got to Toronto and I was like, okay, this feels like home. So anyway, it was a really great experience. Did that answer your question?
Yeah.
Oh, I have not opened it. I was literally signing at the table and then like raced over here, but I promise I will open it.
So, how did you like working on Pursuit of Happiness?
Oh, wow, that was super fun. That was a long time ago. And then, who was that with? Annabeth Gish, who's so great, who does the cons now. I see her around. I loved her in Mystic Pizza, so when I got Pursuit of Happiness, I was super psyched because I really wanted to meet Annabeth Gish, and she was great. And that was a very fun role.
As I said to David Jones, I can go into Twitch.
What is it? Oh, yeah, that was a real bummer, huh? Yeah, that was a shock for everybody.
Talk about Annabeth Gish and being excited to work with her. I love hearing stories of stars being stoked to meet other celebrities because I think everybody here is excited to meet like certain stars. It's always fun to hear like when actors are like, oh my gosh, I get to work with someone cool. Is there anyone that you would love to work with as a director?
Oh my gosh, there's so many. There's so much talent out there. And of course then there are actors that would intimidate the hell out of me to work with. But I'm excited to sort of face that fear as well at some point. When I get there, thinking off the top of my head, I don't know. There's so many to choose from.
Yeah, that's amazing. Over here, hi.
Hi there again. I just have two different questions I'd like to ask you. Overall, what was it like in the Mighty Morphin Power Rangers TV series, like when you were working with Thuy-Tran?
With Tui?
Yeah, Thuy-Tran. Pardon my pronunciation.
Oh, no, that's okay. Me and Tui were like, we were best friends. We were like sisters. And me and David Yost too. Me and Shui she would sleep, like there was the big earthquake I think in 93 or 94, and she was sleeping over my house. We were having a little slumber party. We went through a lot together. That was one scary morning, let me tell you. It sounded like a train was like coming in through the, and then we were both like praying. Well, yeah, it was the craziest. Anyway, more about Tui. She was awesome. She was great. We were very, very good friends.
And also my second question, just reflecting on Jason Narby and Paul Schreier, who played Hulk and Skull, what's it like also working with them overall?
Oh, they were great. They were, you know, they're the comic relief in life as well. Has anybody met them at a Comic-Con before? They're exactly the same. They're great. They're very funny. Sometimes. No, I don't care. But they're always on. I've never not seen Paul not on. Yeah, he's very funny. Kind of like Jason, JDF. He's pretty, like, that's him.
Just gotta follow a little bit of that.
Yeah.
It's cute. Thank you so much. Hi.
So, my question for you is this. When you were younger, you played a superhero on TV, so then you transitioned into Flashpoint, and then you got to show what it was like to be pretty much a real-life superhero for people. How did that make you feel, being able to transition from that?
Right, well, there was a lot of years in between there, because that was my first job as an actor with Power Rangers, and then I went on and I did Felicity and a bunch of other TV series, but getting Flashpoint in that role. Yeah, there is a similarity between the two roles, I guess, between Kimberly and Jules. What was cool about Flashpoint is the writers were awesome. They're really great writers, and they would take actual news stories and then find the story within that, and they would write a lot of the episodes based off of things that really happened. And the cool thing about the show is the Flashpoint, which comes down to that moment, besides being the flashpoint of the gun, but that moment in time when your breaking point, really, when you do I don't want to say the worst thing, but the most desperate thing possible because of a need somehow. So it was really cool, and the guest stars that came in got to have some really awesome roles playing these people that are in real desperate times. So yeah, I feel really lucky and blessed with the whole career that I've had. I've always sort of just worked and consistently and never got really super famous, which I don't think I would really like anyway, but always worked very consistently, which is really great and hard to do. Yeah, so that's good. Doesn't really answer your question either, but you know what I mean.
You do great. You're doing great. It's really just the first panel here today. It's going really well. It's all good. Thank you so much. Hi.
Hi. Amy Jo Johnson.
That's me.
I am probably one of your biggest fans, maybe even the biggest. Unfortunately, I didn't even think of being dressed up as you until yesterday when it was too late.
Oh, damn it.
Next time.
Yeah.
Maybe this is a costume.
My question is, what was your favorite moment as Kimberly Hart with Tommy Oliver?
I don't know. I always liked working with Jason. You know, in the beginning, we were like brother and sister in a way, so we'd get all goofy when we'd have to kiss sometimes and stuff, but I think he kind of liked it. I don't know. It was fun. I've always liked working with Jason.
Let me rephrase.
I didn't answer properly.
What if you were to be Kimberly again?
Oh gosh. Yeah.
And you were to think back to when you were dating Tommy, what would your favorite memory be?
Oh, you want me to go make believe right now?
I love this question. This is
really?
How would adult Kimberly feel?
How would adult Kimberly
about
feel?
You look back on that group.
Oh, I don't know.
Paul.
It's Paul.
We got that.
Well, Kim and Tommy did not smoke pot. But I don't know. Fond memories. First love. That's always, those ones always stick with you.
I like that.
Yeah. Is that good enough?
Yes.
Thanks. Thank you so much. Something that we saw in the video, but we haven't touched on today at all in the panel, is Felicity. You guys, any Felicity fans in the crowd today? Yeah, I was a big fan. What was it like working with JJ?
Oh my god, yeah. So, Felicity, that show was probably the first show I got where the caliber of the people that were coming in to shoot the show and the directors, they would have these amazing movie directors come in and, I don't think I appreciated it as much as I do now in hindsight, looking back on that experience and understanding the people I was working with and what we were making. And I think it's a really special show. It's back on Hulu now, and I'm actually really excited to watch it with my daughter. My daughter's 9, and we just finished Gilmore Girls. Such a good show to watch with oh my god, it was our hit. So I actually have to say I haven't really seen much of any of the work I've ever done. Yeah, I think I've seen 3 Power Ranger episodes and then Felicity, maybe 1 or 2. But I really, being a director now I feel like I can watch myself because now it's just an actor on the screen. But
objectively.
Yeah. And actually I'm really excited to watch the Felicity series.
That's cool. You've talked a little bit about, I I was glad that you brought up during Flashpoint how that was kind of during a moment of transition for you in your life. You've talked about that a little bit with Felicity as well, that you were going through some really tough times in the shooting of that series. I'm just curious as
well, that was sort of... So my mother got really sick when I did the pilot of Felicity, and she ended up passing away 10 months after that. So we were in the middle of shooting the first season when my mom died, and that it really rocked my world. Like, I don't even know how to explain it. It was, I mean, you guys, everybody's gone through crappy stuff, so you get it. So, and then I stayed on for 2 years doing Felicity, and JJ had this knack and really liked to write for the characters, sort of cathartically, things that were going on in their lives. So my character on Felicity, Julie, was searching for her birth mom, as my mother has just passed away. So like he really, like, so it was something to sort of grab onto. So cathartically, it was a good thing, I guess. But I ended up, because I never really got proper time to sort of grieve, because we were shooting. I mean, they stopped production for a week so I could go to the funeral and stuff. Like, they were incredible. And then I went back, and then at some point, like two years later, I sort of completely fell apart. And then that's where I did a couple other TV series in LA, but then that's when I finally left and went to Montreal. And then Flashpoint was a real healing process for me, and really like grounding myself and finding myself. So it was, really grateful for both of those shows.
We're all really glad that you made your way here, right?
Yeah.
So, have you taken any of those lessons that you've learned from directors that you've worked with, like JJ, into your own work as a director?
Yeah, I mean, that's my training ground for directing, and I do fall back on, like, I'm the most comfortable directing when I'm actually shooting and on the set, because I feel like I grew up on a set, basically, for 25 years. So, you know, the biggest learning curve for me with directing has been the prep and getting prepared, and then the editing, the stuff that I never saw, but actually being on the set and working with so many different directors, I think I get it, and I'm excited to, like, you know, do it. and I think the biggest thing is to figure out for a director is people's personalities, and to figure out how to go with the flow at the same time as being the leader, in a way, the captain of the ship, and moving things forward, but letting everybody sort of be a part of it. And then I think the thing that makes me most nervous is actually directing the actors. So, yeah, because I know every actor has their own process, and everybody, I sound like a Canadian now. I just said process, guys.
As opposed to... Is that a Canadian thing?
It's just
as opposed to process?
I always said process, and now it feels weird to say process.
One of us. One of us.
Yeah. Anyway, I know that every actor has a different process. Process. It sounds like process sounds better now.
Yeah.
Okay, anyway. Everybody, so you have to sort of figure out how to help them do the best they can by letting them do their process. Anyway, yeah. Oh, because you can tell I'm like really passionate about it. I'm very excited. I might be boring the hell out of you guys, but I'm
no, it's so interesting.
Super excited.
It's awesome. I think it's great. Hi. Yes. Other question.
Have you watched any Power Rangers with your daughter yet?
So maybe 5 years ago, I did play some shows for her, and she was like, and she thought it was really cool for a second, and then it wasn't really her thing. So, you know, she never got into it. But once in a while, we talk about it. She said, because I get so many gifts coming to the convention, so many little Power Ranger, Pink Ranger gifts. She was like, Mom, if anybody ever broke into our house, they would totally think I was a Power Ranger fan. Like, they would. They totally would.
I always liked that the Pink Ranger had a skirt. I was like...
Why do I like the skirt? I don't like the skirt.
I thought it was cute.
Yeah.
Yeah, I liked it.
Well, the Yellow Ranger actually had a... It was a guy. It was a guy in there.
Yeah.
You know that, right?
Yeah. It's okay.
The Japanese footage, you guys know that.
Just in case they, just in case they don't know.
Well, yeah, so the stunt guy for the Japanese footage of the Power Rangers was a man for the Yellow Ranger. You can tell if you look real hard.
But you were a gymnast before you were a Power Ranger.
I was a gymnast when I was a kid.
Yeah, so you were able to bring some of that physicality to the role.
Yeah, I think that's one of the reasons why I got the role, was because I was a gymnast. Yeah, it helped me out in the audition.
That's awesome. Since you are so passionate about it, I would love for you to tell the crowd a little bit about The Space Between.
Oh, sure.
And, yeah.
So The Space Between is my debut feature film that came out last summer, and it's a heartfelt comedy, and it's about this guy who discovers that his child is not his own. And the movie starts off there, and he goes on this journey to find the biological baby daddy, who happens to be a redheaded university student. So, and I'm really proud of it. It's my first feature, and I kind of love it. I mean, it was a low budget, and it has its quirks, but I would love for you guys to watch it and tell me what you think.
Where did that idea come from for you as a writer?
My first little short film I made is called Bent, which was a little story I wrote about me and my best friend, that in real life we like to go to my mother's grave and drink wine and chit-chat in lawn chairs once in a while, because it's fun, and we cry at the grave and laugh and just like hang out. So that's my first short film. It's called Bent, and it's not a true story. It's just sort of like based off of my relationship with my best friend. But so I made Jackie, the character of Amelia, I play Amelia, be pregnant, and she confesses to her best friend Amelia, because she's pregnant, that the dad, like her husband, is not the father of the baby. She had actually slept with a busboy at work named Danny Baker, and he's a redhead. So at the end of that short film, I say to Jackie, I say, let's hope for a bald baby. Buy a little time. So I just took the seed of that. I thought that was an interesting idea. And then my friend Michael Krim, who's on Flashpoint, in my short film, he played Jackie's husband for like a brief scene, and then I just wrote the whole story based off that for him to start it.
It's like the Amy Jo Johnson expanded universe.
Like every short and The Space Between, and then my other screenplay at Crazier Than You that I'll do down the road, they're all like different, like parallel lives of these same people. But so the movie I'm shooting, Tammy's Always Dying, next month, I didn't write, so it's not my, there's no, Amelia is not in Tammy's Always Dying, although I should stick her in there somehow.
You should do it, yeah, like an Easter egg, I like that, for the loyal fans, yeah. So tell us a little bit about that one in November, whenever you can.
Yeah, I can't talk too much about it, but this one is a tragic comedy, so The Space Between is more of the heartfelt comedy, and this one is a bit more tragic, but it is still a comedy at the same time. But that one is about this woman who threatens to jump off a bridge once a month to keep her daughter tethered to the small town they live in. And it's pretty heavy, but it's beautiful. And this woman, Joanne Sarazin, who I went to the Canadian Film Center last year with, she wrote the film. And I can't wait to tell her story.
Awesome. CSC is so wonderful.
Yeah. So I took about 6 months last year, and I went to the Canadian Film Center through the director's lab just to practice directing and stuff, yeah.
And you do, in addition to directing and music and acting, now you do a bunch of these conventions, which is awesome, and we're all super excited about. What has been some of your favorite con or fan experiences?
Oh my, there's been a few. I've done about maybe 8 to 10 a year for the last 2 years.
So that's a lot.
Yeah. You know what? And one of my favorite things to do is just sort of let people know what I'm doing now, and that I am directing. people, and some of and hearing people's stories of how Power Rangers, when they were kids, like helped so many kids through these like real hard, tough transitions in their lives. Their parents getting divorced, or a parent dying, or them finding out they're gay, or whatever it is, like these real huge moments in their life, and that this TV series that I did 25 years ago, that was my first job, was like their guiding light, like something that really helped them, is really cool to be a part of without even having that intention.
And you're attached to another project now called This Has Been, which has some Comic-Con ties, is that right?
What's that called?
This Has Been.
I've never heard of that.
Sounds like a web series. Oh!
Oh, it has been.
Oh, yes. Sorry. I was saying bean instead of bin.
I'm not that Canadian.
Frozen bean process. This is a weird theme that's happening now. This is bean. Is that... Wow, guys. I interpreted it as it turns out.
I don't know. That has been.
A boot?
So I did...
Should we get them all out of the way now?
I made this little web series last year, which I named the 10-minute little short kind of thing that I haven't released online. I just did like the teaser for it on there, because it was a concept that I was sort of exploring, and it was about this aging actress who had gone bankrupt, and she has to go on a Comic-Con convention with her enlisting her crazy family that she hadn't seen in 20 years. I wrote it, and I was acting in it, starring in it, and directing it. And I honestly didn't love the experience of acting in something so full-on, in such a character, and directing. And I realized when I got in the editing room that I was like, oh, I didn't direct this. I was so in it.
That's so interesting.
Yeah, so I put that project sort of on the shelf for a bit as I focus on Tammy, and I might come back to it at some point, but it wasn't fulfilling me. It wasn't making me super happy.
I love the concept of that, though.
Yeah, I think there's something in there, if it's just a character in a bigger TV show that I sort of develop.
Yeah.
You know, I don't know if that could carry an entire show.
But it's Comic-Con culture is such a big thing now, and I feel like we never see it.
Once in a while.
Yeah.
Yeah, people explore it. There's some older movies about it, and then there's that guy, his name, but Con Man.
Nathan Fillion, yeah.
Such a good show.
So
I watched all that.
Alan Tudyk, yeah.
If you guys haven't seen Con Man, you should watch it. It's actually super funny.
And like Galaxy Quest and stuff.
And Galaxy Quest.
Cool. Yeah, totally.
Which is so great. Which is Enrico Colantoni, who was in Flashpoint.
So good. Oh, we have another question over here. Hi.
Hello. I was just wondering if you could speak to the experience of filming Power Rangers the movie, not the 2017 movie, but the original one that you were in.
The one in Australia. Well, there's two. The first one, we went to Australia, and that was really fun, and we were all a bunch of kids in Australia for like 6 to 8 months. We were there a long time because we had to basically refilm half the movie because they switched out the Dulcias. The original Dulcia was Mariska Hargitay, who went on to like be the... She made like Law & Order, was it?
Yeah.
Yeah, she's fantastic. Why they didn't keep her on, I have no idea. But the new Dulcia was wonderful too. But we ended up, I don't know what all went down with that. Something must have gone down, because that's crazy. That's a lot of money to waste. We filmed half the film and then refilmed it. Anyway, I didn't mind, because I loved Australia. And it was a lot of fun. Yeah. Sort of a boring answer for you, sorry.
No, that was a great question. Thank you. Do we have any other questions? Hi.
She got stuck in the bathroom with one of my best friend's daughters. There was three little girls, and the doorknob came off, and they were stuck in the bathroom, and we were listening to them, sort of panic and calming each other down, and I forget how it all went down, but I think, I don't know if it was Frankie that said it. Somebody was like, it's okay, your mom will get us out, she's a Power Ranger. I can't imagine Frankie saying that. I think it was somebody else. Anyway, we were like, oh my God, that's so funny.
That's adorable. Yeah, Amy Jo Johnson, real life superhero, that's for sure. I think we have one more question over here.
I loved you in Flashpoint. Sad to see that show go, unfortunately. As far as being in the director's chair, putting aside that the latest Power Rangers, more or less, was a 2-hour Krispy Kreme donut commercial.
Wait, what was it? Oh,
wait,
oh, sorry.
Oh,
you didn't like it.
So, I love the show, but as far as the product placement goes, now that you're in the director's chair, how do you balance that creative, being in the creative chair as a director, how do you balance that with the requirements for product placement?
Oh, I don't know. You know what? I'm still directing little indies.
I love that you're using Indiegogo for financing. That's so fun.
Not for Tammy.
Yeah.
We might down the road, because what I love about Tammy, or Indiegogo, is sort of creating an audience for the film before it's even made yet. And because these little indie films, they're hard to have a life. And so it's nice to create, to have people on board. Yeah, you know what? I think it can come in handy, because making a movie is a lot of money. And so, it stings when all you see is, you know, product placement in your face. But sometimes they can hide it, and it's subliminally coming at you. I don't know. I haven't thought too much about it, because I haven't dealt with it much yet. Yeah.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Amy. Yeah. It was so much. Do you have any last words to say?
Yeah, so I'll be here today and tomorrow, so come visit me at the table. And please check out my website, amyjojohnson.com, and just take a peek at my three short films, and then it'll tell you to go to the website for The Space Between. There's a link on there. And I would love it if you guys could watch my movie. It's on iTunes and Google Play and all that. But anyway, nice to be here. And not yet!
We appreciate you.